Hey, what's up? Hope everyone's having a wonderful evening, getting a chance to sit down and relax. So, out of all the comments that I've received, I believe this one I've gotten the most requests for. They said it's very emotional, so be prepared, which I'm a crybaby. I can easily cry, it doesn't take much. So I'm interested to see what it brings. The set, I have a question too for you guys, if you could let me know. Is his stage name self-explanatory, or did he come up with it just? Because however he did, I mean, it's catchy. It's cool, and I've always loved the name, so. But without further ado, here we go. That really nice, gentle, piano melody, and then you see, a car wreck. Most of the time, I think most of us would be like, why would you be playing a melody like that, something like this? But obviously, there's something deeper, which he always has that ability to just get out of you. I'm already kind of like, preparing myself, so. That is, I rarely do this, but that chorus when he comes in, his voice is so commanding right there. Oh my God, that gave me chill. Wow. He is just getting better and better with his vocals. I mean, unbelievable. That was just, yeah, I mean, it caught me like off guard. If I play this like one, like, two more times, please don't hold it against me. I am definitely going to do my best to keep from spoiling the video. You could tell his record label put money into this production. I mean, the two actors are doing a phenomenal job conveying his emotions through his song, which is just, oh my God. His vocals are just getting so dang, just commanding your attention, like bringing you in. And I've never done this for one video this many times rewinding, so please don't hold it against me. I'm just loving this though. It's showing a contrast, and you could always tell, like a lot of directors or a lot of creative people will do it with the imagery, like what I see, like there's a light bright, they're happy, they're smiling, they're hugging, kissing, and then you get these grayer tones and they seem more distant. He seems depressed. So yeah, I'm loving the video.
Thank you.
happy in every bright scene, but for the most part, they were. Guys, I just cannot get over that. That really just hits you for some reason. I don't know. Me personally, I love that up honest with you. Like, I obviously, the distance between them had something to do with the car wreck, because it was an open shot of him and just him. So I was thinking maybe something that, you know, even though they crashed into him, if somebody inadvertently died because of it. I had no idea that it's basically those gray tones that you don't see them speaking, that is her soul. That's lovely. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
song. I mean, this vocalist just is getting better. I guess it was over. Oh my god, that was, yeah, that one was definitely emotional. So far, I have to say my favorite song of his. Oh, it was always Yellow, but this kind of, yeah, takes its place. And phenomenal job that the actress and actor did. I mean, conveying his words, and god, he just improves as a lyricist and as a vocalist. I mean, it's just like Lionel Richie said, the stars are the limit for this guy. I mean, basically saying there are no limits. So I got asked this question today, and they said, you know, it's odd that he isn't more, and we talked about this too, I made a whole video about it, why his marketability has been there. Why haven't you heard of this person? I mean, I only ran across him because I was bored, you know, stuck in the house with the pandemic, looking at YouTube, and I see, oh, you know, best audition ever on American Idol, ? So I clicked it, and if I never did that, I would have never heard about it. But yet, and the commenter said this specifically, but yet, you hear of, gosh, I can't even, you hear of the Island Boys. Now, to be cliche with the gimmick, one of Eminem's verses, and I just got into Eminem because, like I said, I was never big on hip-hop, so I just started paying attention to a little bit of his music since I seen the Guinness Book of World Records involved with you know, what he did. But there was a line that he had in there that really, it's true, because he kind of encapsulated it in his career, you know, his longevity, you know, and he says it's youthful rage and exuberance. Everybody likes to cheer for a nuisance. And that's what those Island Boys are. Nuisance. They're a gimmick. People are just curious about them, and that's why the clicks. That's why the views. But that's kind of gone on with this last generation anyways. I mean, I know that he's come out, Eminem has came out and just said, like, if you listen to the trash that's out today, mumble rappers, I don't listen to rap. Like I said, I barely started liking Eminem. But I know he also had said once that he took the industry by storm because he was white. And yeah, people were curious. I remember so many people like, yo, this white guy could rap like this? That's amazing. But I guarantee right now, if you were to go in with a new account into YouTube, type 1i, Island Boys would probably be in the top 10. But you go there, type in an A, won't see him. Type in an S, you won't see him. Type in American Idol, yes, maybe then. But for himself, this is where I kind of landed on after that Q&A. You know, he had said it himself, he's only into eating and music, that he's legit the most boring person in the world. Those were his words. He's concentrating on his music. He loves what he does with his music, always trying to make him better. I mean, he doesn't realize how grateful we are for this music. But what, and I would have to really look into it to see if that would be the case, but I remember a specific incident when I was in the industry. You believe that your homies, your friends, relatives, you know, are going to steer your career in the right trajectory. But sometimes because their lack of knowledge, you know, of the industry as a whole, they inadvertently are doing more damage than good. So as long as he sees like, oh, I'm booked for this gig here, I'm booked for this, you know, gig there, he should have had endorsements for his, you know, guitar playing. You know, he should have had, you know, opening acts for what a lot of people would say were bigger stars. Since, you know, we know of him, we know that his star is big, but the rest of the world doesn't. So me saying, you know, for bigger stars is just implying for people who are more established. And so I hope he's not relying on any of his homies or his friends or his family to be, you know, his manager. Because if he's just, like I said, if he's just saying like, or seeing, oh, cool, we're going to play at this gig, great. Well, yeah, but they're not up to your level, you know, gigs. You could be selling out, like, I live here in Colorado, and you could be selling out the Pepsi Center if you wanted to. I believe they may have changed their name, so don't hold me to that. But, yeah, love the song. this is going on constant loop. Thanks, guys. You guys are awesome. I don't know if I said it before. I just lost myself in the music, but thank you guys, whoever subscribes. I'd really appreciate it. I don't ever want to get like preachy, like, oh, subscribe, you know, do this, do that. I think I've said it like once. You know, if you like the content, that's awesome that you've you know, decided to watch the videos that I make and follow me. So thank you very much. Honestly, I'm very, very appreciative of it. So that being said, thank you guys for the recommendations. This song was just beautiful. The production of it, beautiful. I mean, the actor and act, I mean, especially the actor, man, he conveyed that awesome. I mean, just incredible. So yeah, hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your evening, and hopefully I might be able to get another one out today or a couple tomorrow. But until then, take care. Until then, take care. Can't even swipe it.